Now, that's one confirmation to assure you that you, Moses, you ain't going by yourself. Anytime you get to the point that you've lost the presence, come on, somebody, you in trouble. And there's some folk that the presence of God used to be up on you. There's a time that even you could look at you and it was a different aura about you, with a different presence about you. But you could tell what presence that you've been in because, amen, you had not been in the presence of God a long time. You could be in the house but not be in God's presence. I don't want to be in the church and not in the presence of God, because in the presence of the Lord is the fullness of God's joy. How can you be in the presence and don't have no joy? The joy of the Lord is your strength. It is a joy that is set before him, that he endures the cross. That's what they said, I need to get in his presence. So that's one confirmation. He said, my presence shall go with him. Now watch this. And I will give you rest. Now watch what he replied. If your presence does not go with me, don't take me up. Amen. Don't take me up. The indicator that God gonna take you up, he gonna, amen, confirm it by his presence. Oh. If you going up without his presence, I'm with somebody. If you going up without his spirit, if you going up, what's taking you up? The devil taking Jesus up into the house of the mountain and showed him. Well, y'all are ready to close the book. Y'all ain't ready for this type of revelation here. We have so many folks going up. What's taking you up? You going up without God?
Yeah.
Because if God is taking you up, there'll be a level of presence. There'll be a level of power. There'll be a level of anointing. That should be up on your life in the midst of you going up. And he take it with him. Peter, James, and John. To the top of the mountain. It was transfigured. Right before the eyes. And then he want to leave that place. See, when God puts you in that place, I want somebody to get God to pray. You ain't going to want to leave that place. See, too many times, what's taking you up? When he took them up, they don't want to leave that place of being up. See, if you ever been up in that place in the supernatural, you don't want to leave that place. That's why I know that some folks ain't never got in that place. Because if you ever get in that place, your value being in that place, I want somebody to get God to praise him. You'll be so excited. You'll be giving God to praise him. Because you got to understand that everything that you prayed for, everything that you sought God for, and now he done thrust you into that place that you're able to experience the glory, that you're able to experience the presence. And when God gets you to that place, don't nothing matter more but staying in that place with God. You have a different attitude. You have a different mindset. That's what I said. I'm ready to get to that place. But you try to clamber to that place without God. You try to get to that place without prayer, without fasting, without consecration. You'll never get to that place with God if you don't get back to prayer, if you don't get back to fasting, if you don't get back to seeking God. That's what I said. I got to get back to that place. And that place don't require you to give up some stuff. You can't stay up in that place if you want to stay and see. Because see won't let you remain in that place. If you get in that place, you got to cut loose some stuff. You got to disconnect yourself from your faith. Because God ain't gonna allow you to stay in that place of glory, that place of power, that place of anointing. But you ain't ready to give up something. That's an answer. I got to get back in that place. There's a place that God would thrust you into. Come on. And it don't matter what folks say, it won't even affect you. You'll be so in the place. Because now he done put you in a secret place. And when you get in that place with God, you can just feel the presence. You can feel the glory of God, and God begin to talk to you. That's why Paul said, he said, I got caught up in the third heaven. I got caught up in paradise, and I heard things that words cannot even utter. He said, I don't know if I was in the body or if I was out of the body, but one thing I know, come on, that amen, I heard something and I felt something, and because of the abundance of the revelation that was given unto me, I'm turning in my flesh, and I said, God, you got to remove it. He asked God three times, and God still didn't remove it. Because when God puts you in that place, there's a thing you want God to remove. He just won't remove it. Because he got to keep you humble. He got to let you know, amen, you didn't put yourself there, but God puts you there. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, it's time for you to get to that place. Moses said, I can't take a people if you don't have them validated by God. Touch your neighbor, say, the only thing you need is the validation of God. Touch your neighbor, say, I need God to validate me. And when God puts you in a place of presence, puts you back in that place with God, you can't let nobody or nothing pull you from that place. The problem we have in the church, God begin to elevate you. God begin to lift you up. And then the next time you look around, you done got with somebody, and they get negative, and they pull you from where God got you at. But in this season of elevation, you got to make up your mind. I ain't going to let nobody separate me from the love of my God. I feel like preaching up in here. I feel the anointing of God here. Touch your neighbor's neighbor. I got to get back in that place. Ain't it amazing that when you got in that place, you had more peace, you had more excitement. See, when you disconnect from that place, you'll come up in the church, and it takes so much to get you primed up. But when you're already in that place, you'll come up in here and give God the praise, because you understand, come on, that even he inhabits the praises of the people. And the problem we have in the church, they ain't never been in that place with God, because ain't no way you can be his glory and still don't want to remain in his glory. We told him, he said, look at here. He said, I'm going to be with you. You ain't going to be by yourself. And then he asked God, he said, look at here. He said, if you're really with me, I need you to show me something. He said, show me your glory. That's it. I need the glory to come back. When the glory come back in the house, you can experience a real move of God. He said, show me thy glory. And then what he told him, he said, no man can see my face and live, but there is a place that's beside me that I'll put you in the cliff. I'll put you in a solid place and call my glory to pass by. That's your neighbor, say neighbor. He got to put you back in a place that his glory can pass by. That's your neighbor, say neighbor. I got to get in a solid place. He put him in a place of cliff. And the Bible said that he put his hind part. He said, you can't see my face, because can't no man see my face and still live. But I put you in a place that you can see my hind parts. Touch your neighbor, say neighbor. Even in the natural realm, you don't let everybody see your hind parts. It's only knowing that you're in a relationship with God. So when you get a relationship with God, there's some things about God that he begin to show you. There's some things in the river of spirit that you begin to see. That's why he said, eyes are not seen. You have ears heard. You've got in the heart of things that God has for you. That's your neighbor, say, neighbor. I got to get back in that place. The first thing you got to understand, to get in that place, you got to recognize that you done lost your place. You'll never get back in that place if the devil keep convincing you that you're already in that place. When you recognize there was a place in God that you were once worth, and all of a sudden you're not there no more. Let me indicate to you that you know you're not in that place. But it takes so much for you to say amen. But it takes so much for you to lift up your hands and give God the praise. It's indicate to me that you're not what you used to be. Because when people got a relationship, they can come through the doors and they begin to praise God. But they already know that the battle's already won. Can I breathe like I'm feeling? I feel like preaching. That's your neighbor here. And say, neighbor, I got to get back in that place. And when you realize that you're not in the place that you used to, you got to say, Lord, I come before you as long as I know how. Lord, I need you to have mercy on me. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor. But we all get in that place. The Lord start doing something. Just when you answer, the Bible declares, when they got in the place, they was in that place. And it was all on one accord. And suddenly there was a sound. It came from heaven as a rushing mighty wind. And it filled the place where they were sitting. And I want you to know that he's in this place. We not on one accord. to get back in that place. It's calling me to a higher place. I gotta get in that place. When you get in that place with God, don't nothing matter but feeling His presence. When you get in that place with God, all the thing you wanna do is give God the praise. Cause you already know that He's taking me from faith to faith, from glory to glory. Now somebody in hell and say, neighbor, I gotta get back in that place. There was a time when you was in that place. You would come to church and you would give God the praise. You'll praise Him like you lost your mind. I feel like preaching. I feel like giving the praise to somebody in here. Y'all gonna make me preach. Cause I feel like giving God the glory. Look at Moses now. He said, I got to see it glory. I don't know about you. You can have the preaching, but I want the glory. You can have the singing, but I want the glory. When you got the glory of God, you can walk in the place. And before you know it, He done gave you favor. Cause it ain't you. It's the glory of the Lord. The same Moses, when he came out the temple, the Bible said that the glory of the Lord was so on his face that they looked up on him and they saw the glory. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, let me get back in that place. You're preaching like the preachers, but they went in the holy place. They began to pray to God. They burned incense. And when they came out of the place, the glory of the Lord has filled the place. And even the priest couldn't preach. Because the glory of the Lord pull on somebody in here and say, neighbor, you used to shine. You used to have a presence. You used to feel His anointing. But you got so dry that you can't say amen. You got so dry that you can't feel His presence. That's your neighbor. And say, neighbor, I can't go nowhere. I got to have His presence. I got to have His presence at work. When I get up in the morning, I got to have His presence. When